Hi everyone, my name is Pauline. As a nuclear medicine resident, I often see patients with prostate cancer. This is why I made a series of videos in which I explain everything related to the prostate. From benign prostatic hyperplasia to prostate cancer to some important diagnostic tools. You can choose to watch them all, or you can go to the playlist and watch the videos that seem interesting to you. In this video, I will explain what PSA is, what its role is in the screening for prostate cancer, and how to interpret the PSA test results. PSA is a protein made by prostate cells. It is normally secreted into ducts in the prostate, where it helps make semen. When PSA leaks into the blood, it can be measured with a blood test called the PSA test. In prostate cancer, more PSA gets into the blood. But a high PSA level is not a proof of cancer, and many other things can cause a false positive test result. For example, blood PSA levels are often increased in men with prostatitis or prostate hyperplasia. Even things that disturb the prostate gland, such as riding a bicycle, may increase PSA levels. Also, some prostate glands naturally produce more PSA than others. PSA levels go up with age, and African American men tend to have higher PSA levels in general than men of other races. The PSA test was originally approved by the FDA in 1986 to monitor the progression of prostate cancer in men who had already been diagnosed with the disease. In 1994, FDA approved the PSA test to be used in conjunction with a rectal exam to aid in the detection of prostate cancer. Until about 2008, many doctors had encouraged yearly PSA screening for prostate cancer beginning at the age of 50. As more was learned about both the benefits and harms of prostate cancer screening, a number of doctors began to caution against routine population screening with the PSA test. On the one hand, the PSA test is useful for detecting early-stage prostate cancer, especially in those with many risk factors. But on the other hand, PSA screening may find very slow-growing prostate cancers that would never threaten someone's life. As a result, screening may lead to treatments that are not needed. The current recommendation is that average-risk men under the age of 55, over the age of 69, or with a life expectancy of less than 10 years should not be screened for prostate cancer. Men between 55 and 69 should discuss the pros and cons of PSA screening with their doctor before making a decision. PSA levels are measured in terms of the amount of PSA per volume of fluid tested. Doctors often use a value of 4 nanograms or higher per milliliter of blood as a sign that further tests, such as a prostate biopsy, are needed. The first thing you should do if the PSA value is elevated is to wait 6 weeks and have it repeated. If it is still elevated, a biopsy may be recommended. Rather than subject everyone with an elevated PSA to a biopsy, some doctors measure free PSA in patients with a total PSA between 4 and 10 nanograms per milliliter. The standard PSA test measures total PSA, which include both PSA that is bound to other proteins and PSA that is not bound. The free PSA test measures free PSA only. Free PSA is linked to benign prostate conditions such as prostate hyperplasia, whereas bound PSA is linked to cancer. The percentage of free PSA can help tell you what kind of prostate problem someone has. If both total PSA and free PSA are higher than normal, this suggests prostate hyperplasia rather than cancer. If total PSA is high but free PSA is not, cancer is more likely and more testing, such as a biopsy, should be done. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you want to see more of my videos where I explain various medical topics in an easy and understandable way, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell button if you want to get notified every time I upload a video.